Hi there, everybody, and a very pleasant good evening to you wherever you may be. It's time for Dodger Baseball and Dodger Baseball Chronicles. My name is Pete Trunk, and my co-host is Robert Cole. We're going to do a show tonight on for a tribute for our late partner, Ronnie Rabinowitz. So this is going to be the Ronnie Rabinowitz tribute show. And I hope you all enjoy it. I hope you all listen to it. And before I get too emotional and send it over to my partner, Robert Cole, I'm gonna say that Ronnie Rabinowitz was every bit 100% the soul of this show. And even before this, when we did Comfortably Zone radio shows, before we went on so-called TV, if you want to call it that, with YouTube, Ronnie was the soul of the whole thing. Ronnie Rabinowitz unexpectedly and suddenly passed away about a month ago. And we here at Dodger Baseball Chronicles are never going to delete his portion of the introduction to this show. When this show is introduced in the future, tonight and in the future, it will always have a picture of me, a picture of Ronnie Rabinowitz, and a picture of Robert Cole. And it will remain that way as long as whatever. It's going to just remain that way. And it should remain that way. Ronnie Rabinowitz was, I probably don't have to tell most of you, was a mensch. Ronnie had his beliefs, but he never argued with anyone. He never called names. He was an incredible guy. And, you know, the more I think about it, the more I think, you know, we should all try, at least I should. I shouldn't tell other people what to do, should try to be more like Ronnie Rabinowitz in the remaining years of my life. And that is to be a mensch as best I can. He was a little kid. He grew up in Wisconsin. His daddy was a lawyer, and his daddy was a powerful lawyer, powerful. We're talking Kennedy, JFK. We're talking Kennedy, RFK. We're talking Rockefeller. We're talking big time lawyer. One day, Ronnie's father came home and said to him, "How would you like to go see the Brooklyn Dodgers at Milwaukee's County Stadium?" This was 1953. Ronnie was going on 7. And he said, "Oh my God, you mean Jackie Robinson?" He said, "Yeah, I can get you to meet the Dodgers and I can get you to meet Jackie Robinson." And Ronnie was beside himself. He counted the days, et cetera, et cetera. The day came, they went to see the Milwaukee Braves versus the Brooklyn Dodgers at County Stadium. And Ronnie tells the story, and it makes me smile to this day. He never was at a baseball game where he wished it was over in the first and second and third and fourth innings. He wished it was over because he knew at the end of the game, his dad was going to bring him down to the clubhouse and meet Jackie Robinson along with the other Dodgers. And that's exactly what happened. The game was over. His father took him down into the bowels of County Stadium. They waited. They got a pass. Jackie sent word out to let them in. They went into the Dodger clubhouse, and the rest is history. Jackie and Ronnie became fast friends. And you might say to yourself, "Well, wait a minute. A 35-year-old and a 7-year-old became friends?" Yes, they did. They became fast friends. And they traded letters back and forth for years and years. Books were written about it. Ronnie was on TV shows, being interviewed about it. And it's all there for you to see. Larry King show, et cetera, et cetera. He's even mentioned at the Hall of Fame by Jackie's plaque. Ronnie Rabinowitz was one of a kind. And I'm going to punt it over to my buddy, my friend, Robert Cole now, and maybe he can add a little bit more that I'm forgetting. Robert?
Okay, Peter. You summed it up pretty good. Ronnie didn't really have friends or enemies. He had people, okay? And he was one of the people. And, you know, people, whether they agreed with him or didn't agree with him, by the end of the day, you have a conversation with Ronnie Rabinowitz and you were one of his people. It didn't matter who you were, didn't matter your political beliefs, your religious beliefs, okay? You were one and the same. And he was unique in that fashion. As Peter said, you know, Ronnie unfortunately passed away April 27th, okay? Right up to that day, okay, he kept his passion for baseball and the Dodgers alive. 2 days before he passed, he was still putting the scores of the Dodger games on Facebook. I mean, that's how passionate he was, okay? He was a fighter. He was fighting to keep on going, okay? We stopped doing shows, waiting for him to get better, hoping he would get better, okay? He kept insisting that we do shows, okay? Peter said, no, we're going to wait for you to come back. So it's the three of us doing these shows again. We're going to continue the shows. It'll be Peter and me. Occasionally we'll have a guest, but no one will ever replace Ronnie.
Never.
Okay? No one. And we will continue, as Peter said, to have him, you know, on the masthead, on the introduction, okay, just to remind us, just to keep Peter and me in line, okay, in case we stray a little bit. But we're going to keep this short because this is a tribute to Ronnie and just to Ronnie, and we hope you appreciate it, okay? We hope that you understand where we've been, why we've been gone so long, and we will be back soon, but Ronnie will always be with us.
Very well said, Robert. Thank you very much. And to all our watchers and listeners, we really appreciate your heartfelt, I've gotten so many letters and not letters nowadays, but emails and messages, and just, it's crazy. Everyone loved Ronnie and we love him too. And, he'll never die, really, on this show anyway. We will always keep his name alive. Thank you, Robert Cole. My name is Peter Trunk. This is Dodger Baseball Chronicles. Thank you for watching.